On December 8th, the Supreme Court will hear oral argument in Harris v. Arizona Independent Redistricting Commission, a case that challenges the constitutionality of the Commission's state redistricting plan. The Campaign Legal Center filed an amicus brief with the Supreme Court on behalf of former Justice Department officials in support of the plan. CLC legal fellow Danielle Lang, who worked on the brief, explains.
The essence of the case is what's called a one-person, one-vote challenge. That means that the appellants are arguing that there's been an unfair distribution in the number of people that are in the districts, that some districts in Arizona have less people and some districts have more people.
The one-person, one-vote principle does not require that state legislative districts have exactly equal populations. The standard is whether minor deviations, like the ones in Arizona, are in furtherance of legitimate and rational state policies.
They say that the plan was created in order to benefit Democrats, create a partisan advantage by underpopulating Democratic districts and overpopulating Republican districts.
But the district court held that the deviations were not motivated by partisanship. Instead, in this case, the deviations in population were motivated by the Commission's effort to comply with Section 5 of the Voting Rights Act. Section 5 requires state and local jurisdictions covered by the Act to receive preclearance from the Justice Department before making any changes in voting or election laws. This is to ensure that the changes don't have a harmful impact on minority voters.
Since the court found that Section 5 compliance actually motivated the commission, the plaintiffs have gone on to argue that Section 5 compliance is also not a rational or legitimate interest for redistricting. This is a very strange conclusion. In fact, 8 Supreme Court justices have held that Section 5 compliance is a compelling state interest, and the court had upheld Section 5 4 times. The appellants argue that Section 5 compliance is no longer a legitimate or rational justification for the 2012 plan because the court in Shelby County in 2013 held that Section 4 of the Voting Rights Act is no longer constitutional. This argument does not hold any water. First of all, Shelby County is a case about Section 4, not Section 5. It simply held that the Section 4 coverage formula is no longer valid going forward. At the time of the redistricting, Section 5 compliance was clearly a rational and legitimate justification because it was legally required of Arizona.
The Campaign Legal Center brief explains the serious ramifications this case could have if the court adopts the proposed rule of the appellants.
16 states were affected by preclearance. 9 states were covered in their entirety by preclearance, and 7 other states were partially covered by preclearance. The Campaign Legal Center brief shows something that is unremarkable, which is that states and cities did in fact take into account Section 5 compliance when they created their plans. Between 2010 and 2013, 1,160 redistricting plans, state and local, were submitted to the Department of Justice for preclearance. If the court adopts the rule that appellants propose, which is incorrect, it would call into question all of these plans. That means each of these districts would have to spend time defending their redistricting plans and incur great legal costs. It would create great political instability and for no reason whatsoever. Under Shelby County, if any of these states or localities wish to redistrict without consideration of preclearance, they're free to do so. We shouldn't make them do so if they don't wish to, and nothing in Shelby County suggests that we should. This case should not be a hard case, but it's an incredibly important case and could have ramifications across the country.
To read the Campaign Legal Center's amicus brief, please visit campaignlegalcenter.org.